Good morning to all the students. In the last lecture, what we have learned, that is gears. Gears are used to transmit motion and power between rotating shafts. So gear means these are the tooth wheels. So there is a progressive engagement between the meeting pin and the motion is transmitted from one shaft to another. Now we know that last time we discussed the what are the gears, what are the applications. So it is used in different industries, automotive, agriculture, marine, turbine industries. Then also, what are the materials which are used for the gears? Then, what is the advantage of gear? It transmits the exact velocity ratio. It is a positive drive element as compared to belt and rope drive. Then also, we have discussed last time the classification of gears. So we know that gears are classified according to the position of axis of shafts. So, shafts are parallel, shafts are intersecting, and shafts are neither parallel nor intersecting. So today we'll see the first type of the gear, that is spur gear, and then we'll see the two terminology of the gear. So spur gear means what? In this case, the shafts are parallel. The spur gear is mounted on parallel shafts. But here, the teeth of this spur gear, which cut parallel to the axis of the shaft or gear, that is the one specific thing. Now, here, if we consider the two external gears, then both are rotated in the opposite direction. If we consider one internal gear, means the teeth are cut on inner surface, then when there is engagement between internal gear and external gear, so both gears are rotated in the same direction. What is the main application of these spur gears? It is used in rolling mills, steel mills, also it is used in watches. Okay. So, in this chapter, mainly we are going to study only the spur gear. Now, next part is the gear tooth terminology. Okay, now the first term is what? Pitch cylinder. Now, pitch cylinder means what? It is the imaginary friction cylinder. Because we know that when there is an engagement between the two gears, so there is a contact between the teeth of the gear. So, there is a friction between the meeting teeth. So, here pitch cylinder means these are the imaginary friction cylinder which rolls without slipping. So, we know that it is a gear, it is a positive drive element, there is no slippage. So, this cylinder means it is a, these are the imaginary friction cylinder. When we use, suppose, cutting plane perpendicular to the axis of that gear and the resultant section, it becomes circle. That circle is known as pitch circle and diameter of this circle is known as pitch circle diameter. So, here we consider this center line which indicates the pitch circle. Now, the next term is the circular pitch. So, it is the distance which is measured along the pitch circle from one point on the tooth to the corresponding point on the adjacent tooth. So, now this figure shows some portion of the gear. So, either we consider two teeth, okay, and here I have mentioned all the different terms which are related to the gear. So, circular pitch, it is the distance which is measured along the pitch circle from one point on this tooth to the corresponding point on the adjacent tooth. So, circular pitch is equal to, mathematically it is expressed as pi into d by t. D is the pitch circle diameter of the gear and t is the number of teeth on the gear. The next term is what? Diametral pitch. Diametral pitch, it is the ratio of number of teeth on the gear to the pitch circle diameter of the gear. Then, a very important term, that is a module. Actually, mathematically, module, it is the ratio of pitch circle diameter of the gear to the number of teeth on the gear. But, with the help of module, we can specify the size of the gear. All the parameters of the gear, which depends upon the value of module. Module, which is used to specify the size, means it shows how the gear is big or small. Because, here, while procurement of the gear, so module is very important term along with this number of teeth. So, from the module and number of teeth, pitch circle diameter of the is decided. So, from the module we can decide how the gear is big or small. So, module is the very important term. Or in design of gear, so size of the gear is depend upon the value of module. Now, next term is what? Addendum. Now, this portion, that is the radial height of the tooth about the peace circle is known as addendum. A value of the addendum is equal to 1 module. Okay. So, if we know the module, so we can calculate addendum. Then, dedendum is what? It is the radial depth of the tooth below the peace circle. So, dedendum is equal to 1.1578 module. Now, the next term is what? Clearance. Now, we know that when there is a meeting between the two gears, okay, so now it is a radial clearance or difference between the top of the one tooth to the bottom of the tooth of another gear. So this difference is known as clearance. Okay, then next we have to consider tooth thickness. It is the thickness of the tooth which is measured along the peace circle. Then face width means what? It is the width of the tooth parallel along the axis of the gear. Then space width means what? It is the space between the two consecutive teeth of the gear. Then here we can see the next term, that is the backlash. Backlash means what? It is the difference between the space width and tooth thickness. Theoretically it is zero, but if it is zero, then teeth will get jammed. So it should be non-zero practically, that backlash value, because it is a difference between tooth thickness and space width. Then here we consider this portion, top land. That is the top portion of the tooth. Bottom land means that is the bottom portion of the tooth. So the portion of the tooth between the top land and the peace circle, which is known as flat face, and the portion of the tooth between the peace circle and the bottom land is known as flank, and the face and flank which forms the profile of the gear. So, profile of the gear means what? The face and flank which describe the curve of that gear tooth, that is known as profile. So, we know that also gears are operated in pairs. So, the smaller gear or a driver which is called as pinion. Okay. And another gear which is known as gear wheel, which is the driven. Another thing is what? Last term is what? This is a fillet radius. Now, it is a curved portion of the tooth at the bottom, which is known as fillet radius. Then, important term is what? Rag gear. Rag gear means what? It is a straight-sided gear. Okay. Here we consider this line, which is a pitch line. Means, here we assume that the pitch circle diameter of that gear is infinite. So, rag gear actually which is used to cut, rag cutter, which is used to cut the teeth. And rag gear means it is a straight-sided gear. The main purpose of the gear is to reduce the speed. So, that term is known as gear ratio. Gear ratio means it is the ratio of number of teeth on the driver to the number of teeth on the driven to the number of teeth of the driver. That is, this ratio is known as gear ratio. So, with the help of this, we can reduce the speed of that particular shaft from driving to driven shaft. So, these are the all terms which are related to the gear tooth. So, what we have learned today, that is what do you mean by spur gear? Okay, what are the applications of spur gear? Spur gear means these are the gears which are used to transmit the power between two parallel shafts, but in this case, the teeth are cut parallel to the axis of the shaft. Then we have to learn all the terms which are related to the gear tooth. So in the next lecture, we will see what is the working principle of gear. Thank you. Thank you very much.